Civil society organizations operating in the Rwenzori region have attributed the increase in teenage pregnancies to traditional marriages where girls are married off early.
Actually, it is contributing to teenage pregnancy because people still take it as more holding tradition. When the child is 16 years old, or maybe when the child starts her menstruation period, she's grown up. This child needs to get married. This child, yeah? Now parents start looking at this child as a source of income. You even hear say, ah, Akasukari is growing. Hmm? There is maturity in this child.
In some areas, especially in the mountainous areas, where we have our sisters and brothers, the Bakonjo, for them, their culture at times also is embedded in this voice. For example, if a girl is 15 years and above, they feel this girl is ready to get married. So that culture is within their cultures in those areas, and you find most of the girls are married in those areas.
Victims of early marriages have explained how they were forced into starting families.
I got pregnant while in school and I dropped out. My auntie suggested I get married, asserting that I had reached the age that our culture approves a girl to get married. When we went to meet the chairman, who also called the police, the man threatened to kill himself and the police dropped the matter. When I got pregnant, my auntie decided to mediate with the man who was responsible instead of taking matters to the police. However, after the man paid hospital bills, he disappeared, leaving me with all the responsibilities.
Records from Girls Not Brides Uganda, the organization teaming up with Joy for Children to fight teenage pregnancies and child marriages, indicates that between ages 15 and 17, 34% of girls in Uganda are forced into child marriage. A total of 200 teenage pregnancies were reported in Kasese District. Leaders have condemned the practice of traditional marriages organized by cultural leaders.
Majority of the cases happen and are never reported. When we come to Kasese Municipality in town here, when we approach the CDO's office, in a period of 2 months, over 250 girls.
The 2022 police crime report indicates that a total of 3,620 cases of aggravated defilement were reported to police, compared to 3,783 cases reported in 2021. The Alberton region registered the highest number of cases of aggravated defilement with 244 cases, followed by Kampala Metropolitan North with 242 cases, while Rwenzori West came in the third position with 228 cases. With the high cases of teenage pregnancies reported in Kasese, leaders have faulted police for not enforcing tough penalties on sexual offenders.
Most of times, I will blame police to a certain extent, but I also blame the parents to some other extent. Police, if they are going into the connivance of these cases, telling that they are reporting to you, then for you say, first go and settle it, and then you see. You get it? Maybe, if that is happening, it is unfortunate.
Authorities in the region, however, say a number of interventions are being done to tackle the issue at hand. Story compiled by Jonathan Tsingwire for the news.